Coffee drinkers, what's happening? This vlog is just apropos of nothing, but I was feeling kind of inspired. I'm looking at chordal harmony. I'm making a video course about that for Janek's Bass Studio. And I sat down to work a few things out saying, okay, well, the very first exercise in chordal harmony is just playing major scales in tenths. And that exercise is in there. It's like there's an etude that goes with it as well. Something like that, something very melodic, very nice to get you in the vibe, but how can we take that to the next level? What is it that I do with that material that takes that simplicity to the next level and in terms of melody, in terms of groove? And here it is. Everything you just heard in the beginning of this video was all just two notes maximum at the same time. Fancy little things thrown in for good measure and for melodicism. But everything is just a root note and a melody note. And I was like, why don't I throw the camera up? Why isn't the next vlog? You know, I've been waiting to do the footage from Bob's tour, from the stuff in Brazil just now, and that's just kind of piling up. Why don't I make this vlog, the next vlog, about playing very melodically, very groovy, with just two notes, because everyone can get into that. If you're a bass player, it doesn't matter what kind of musician you are, a bass player, guitar player, piano player even. And then expanding on that. You know, so far I was just playing pretty much diatonic, so everything was in C, even though I was starting out in A minor. All the notes you can find in a C major scale, harmonized in tenths, but I was starting A minor and a passing chord of F major to the E minor. And you notice how when I play a lick, something like that, maybe the melodic idea, the little soloistic idea in the middle ends and I don't have time to get back on the one, and I play maybe the two or the three instead of every time coming on the one, two, three, four. See, I missed the one, but you still feel the time. So this kind of exercise, this kind of playing, although it's quite simple because it's just a root and a melody note, generally intense like this, it incorporates so many things about sound and time, about what I always talk about, and that's a prime example of that, playing the space, not being afraid to, you know, instead of scrambling from this position down here to get back up to play the downbeat, maybe physically not having the time because this ends on the downbeat, not being afraid to just say, okay, you know what, I'm gonna let it go. It doesn't matter if I come back on a three, it doesn't matter if I let four bars of silence go, you know. That's a great thing to experiment with if you're soloing, especially if you'd like this and it's just you, the band, they're going bass solo and the band's dropped out and away you go. Kind of fun to experiment and pull the audience in, you know, and just drop out for a bar, two, three, four, five bars sometimes. But keep the time, as long as you have the time and as long as anything you play really sits well within that time, that's a really fun experience for the audience and for you, and something you can, you know, create tension with and release tension and go with repetition and change and all those things that I talk about when it comes to improvising. It doesn't just have to be crazy angular soloistic stuff, it can be this stuff. You can be creating the repetition and change creating that dynamic with silence and sound. There's so many ways to do it, and that was what is on, that was, that is what's on my mind today as I look through chordal harmony and take some of these, the ideas out of this book to create an entire video course around it, talking about this kind of stuff, not just kind of static chords and composition necessarily. It doesn't have to all be like that, or just single note reharmonizations. I want to talk about how to incorporate that into your playing so that it, you know, it's not something you use all the time. And if you do use it all the time, you probably get fired pretty quickly. But it's something that's really nice to have in the toolbox and something that is really fun to practice. It's a great way to work on time and sound and just all of the things I talk about. So that is why today's vlog is happening. Back on the couch with the pedals, with the bass, with the book. If you are new to this book, there's a link below this video for it. If you don't know what this is all about, you can get physical copies on Amazon. You can get digital copies with the video download at my e-store. All the links for all the books, including Chordal Harmony, are below. And if you're not hip to Janek's bass studio, that's bassstudio.janekgwizdala.com. There's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of video lessons kind of like this. That's why I'm working on this stuff today, is to produce a new course for that. Be out in about 10 days, something like that, 2 weeks. And I'll play out this video with some more ideas. No looper this time. I mean, I you know, this is kind of a cool thing to put in the looper and jam to, but really getting away from the looper and just working on my own time and sound is what today's practice session is about. Hopefully that can be part of your practice session if you dig this kind of material. Let me know. Give me some feedback. Leave me some comments and questions below this video. I'm Janek Gwizdala. Today's vlog is done, and I'll leave you with a little more music. Thank you.